Dear brothers, tonight, inshallah, in very brief, I would like to highlight a few points about dua, its rules and regulations, manners while we are making dua to Allah Azza wa Jal. But before we start into our topic, I would like to explain very briefly the nature of dua. The word dua in Arabic, it means calling upon or calling someone. When you use dua in Sharia, it means calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and praying to Him. But I jump quickly to the manners of dua. There are some important things that we need to keep in our mind when we make dua. Number one, when we make dua, it has to be sincere. If you are busy, don't make dua. If you are hurry to go somewhere, don't make dua. You know, sometimes people raise their hand quickly and they say, Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana, ameen, and then they leave. Don't make dua, because dua is a communication between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. And when you talk to Rabbul Alameen, you talk to Rabbul Alameen with concentration, khushu', and with need. You show that you really paying attention and you respecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's number one. Number two, when you start making dua, you start with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any type of thanking Allah, praising Him, and thana'ullah, hamd Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you send salat and salam upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And then you ask for your own maghfirah, and you ask repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You repent to Allah before you ask anything. These are the manners before you start your dua. Number three, that when you make a dua, you should have complete yaqeen and you are firm that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to your dua. And Allah azza wa jal, He promised. He says, Ud'uni astajib lakum. You ask me, I will give it to you. Number four, when we make dua, we should not show that we are hurry and sometimes impatient. Sometimes people, when they make dua two, three times and they get tired and they start complaining. And they say, oh, I've been making dua. I ask so many times. I make istikhara, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not answer me. So do not show impatient. Be patient and be faithful in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometime Allah azza wa jal answer your dua in a different way. In hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, whenever you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you right away, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you little late, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you something better than that. In another hadith, Prophet says there are three ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond your dua. Number one, you ask Allah something, He will give you what you ask for. Two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give you what you ask for, but He will give you something better than that. Number three, that what you asking was not good for you, and He knows, so He will reward you in the day of judgment. There is no such dua that you say from your mouth and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reject that dua. Each and every sentence comes out from your lips, Allah azza wa jal respond that, but it's a different way. Not necessarily the answering of the dua mean that whatever you ask for has to be granted on the same time. Number five, that when you make dua, at that time you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala three times. And something is very important, you repeat it three times and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number six, that you do not make dua against yourself, against your wealth, against your family or children or any other living being. You do not make negative dua. Make a positive dua and be positive in your dua. And negative dua only if someone hurt you so bad, or someone hurt Islam or Muslim. Someone hurt you because of your Islam. So you may ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but still in very positive way. Next, that when you make a dua, you do not scream and you do not yell in your dua. And don't be very, very slow. Sometimes people, they make dua and they do not even move their lips. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hadith Qudsi, أَنَا مَعَ عَبْدِي بِي إِذَا تَحَرَّكَتْ شَفَتَاهُ. I will be with my slave and servant as long as his lips are moving with my thana and dua. So when you make dua, at least you listen to yourself. And when you make a dua, you make in a way that you showing that you are really in need and you can hear your own voice. But if you are not moving your lips, so you are not making dua, you are thinking about dua. So this is something very important. Next, when you make dua, you be guilty of the sins, you know. And first of all, you make istighfar and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. And then before you ask something else, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. At the same time, be thankful to Allah's blessing and His favors. Next, when you make dua, you plan for it, you know, and wait for the good opportunity and good timing. Zakariya alayhi salatu wassalam was waiting for the best timing for dua. And one time he came to Maryam alayhi salatu wassalam and he saw so many fruits, and the fruits which were not in the season for those fruits. And then he asked her, Min ayna laki hada? Where you got those fruits and food? Qalat huwa min indillah. She said that it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The door was locked. There is no way to come anybody or enter anybody. And then she has the fruits that it is not their season. At that time there was no, you know, cold store, so you can have, you save the or preserve the fruits. Subhanallah, when Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam saw different foods on different time, hunalika da'a Zakariya rabba, same time, and he get back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he make dua. He said, oh Allah, I am too old to ask this. However, if you can give a food to Maryam without season, you can give me son anytime you want. And then he make dua for Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond his dua at the same time. So you wait for the best timing and you plan for dua, such as there is so many different times we're going to talk about. So you plan, you say on such and such day, on such and such time, on such and such hour, I'm going to make a dua. So you plan for that. So you get ready yourself that you are making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that means you paying attention to your dua. Also, when you make a dua, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with Asma'il Husna, that you mention His beautiful names. And then you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you asking tawbah, you say qabilu tawb. You say ya ghaffar or ya ghafoor. If you asking Allah's blessing, you say ya Rahman, ya Rahim, you know, ya Hannan, ya Mannan, ila hadal qiyas. And when you make dua, at that time, if it is possible, you make wudu first. If it's possible. Wudu is not necessary in dua, but if it is possible, make wudu. If it's possible and the timing for prayer, then pray. Because dua after prayer is accepted. Also, when you make dua and you're making dua for someone else, don't forget to make dua for yourself first. Because you need first. Nobody is, you know, beyond of the importance of dua. So first of all, you ask yourself and then you ask for someone else. Also, when you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make sure that you did not drink something haram, you did not eat something haram, you are not wearing haram, and your blood is not came from haram food. Make sure you have halal food, and you live in halal, you wear halal, and you drink halal, you eat halal before you raise your hand. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if a person come from far away, and then he goes and hold the star of Kaaba, hold to the curtain of Kaaba, and the door of Kaaba, and he say, ya Rabbi, oh my Lord, but the problem is that he drink haram, he ate haram, and he wear haram, and his flesh and blood came from haram sources. Anna yustajabu laha. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond his dua. Next, when you make dua, make sure you make dua for the salihin, for the sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'in, for the aima, for the ulama, and all the righteous people, and all the pious people till the day of judgment. And when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you put your hasanat and good deeds as a wasila. You say, oh Allah, if I did for you, then please accept my dua. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua at that time. After you give charity, when you give charity or sadaqah, you make dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond that dua.